Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. Today's Leetcode question is last stone waits. Okay, so in this particular question we have given an array stones. What we have to do in this question is we have to take the two largest values out of this array, and we have to see if those two largest values are same. If they are same, then we are not doing anything. We simply will remove them out of the array. If they are not same, then we'll insert the difference, the absolute difference of both the elements into the array. Okay. Okay. And the last value which will be remained, which will be with us, will output that value. If we are left with no value, then we'll simply return 0. Okay. So let's try one approach for this question. Let's see over here. The elements in the stone are greater than 0. So what we can do is, I'm traversing through this array, in each traversal I'm finding out two maximum elements, then I'm checking if they're equal or not, and doing the stuff that is mentioned to us. And in that place I can write 0. Okay, so what I'm telling you to do is, so in this traversal, I'll find two largest values. So in first iteration I'll get these two. I see these two values are not, I see the greatest two values are not equal, so I will have to insert the sum, the difference of these two values into our array. Okay, so what we can do is, at one place I can insert the difference, which will be 1. At another place I can insert 0. Why have I inserted 0? Because it is mentioned that all the elements in our array will be greater than 0. So okay, after this, and whenever all my array elements will be 0, I'll understand I have came across all the elements. But this will give us complexity big of n square. Why? Because in each traversal I'm finding out minimum x and minimum and maximum. So instead of this, what I can have an data structure through which what will happen is, I can have a data structure which will give me the maximum values in every turn. Okay, so if you think of such a data structure, you'll get a queue. Okay, priority queue. So what priority queue will give you the largest values. Okay, so what I'm doing in this case is, I'm simply pushing all the values into a priority queue. So internally, priority queue will sort these values. It will sort these values as, 8 will be at the top, then 7 will be there, 4, 2, 1, and 1. And then in each iteration, I'll get the maximum value, okay? I'll find two maximum values in each iteration and I'll check if those two values are equal. If those two values are equal, then I'll simply not do anything. But in case those two values are not equal, I'll push the difference of those two highest values into our priority queue. And at last, if I'll get a single value in my queue, priority queue, then that will be my answer. If in case my priority queue gets empty, then I have to simply return 0 in that case. Okay, let me focus on the code part right now. Here I have declared my queue and pushed all the elements of the array stones into a queue. I loop until my size is greater than 1, and once my size becomes equals to 1, I'll return out of less than 1 or 1. I'll simply break out of the loop. Here I have find the first element, here the second highest element, and if the two values are not equal, I'll find the difference of those two elements and I'll push it into our queue. And at last, if I see my priority queue size is 1, I'll return the top of the priority queue. That will be my answer. And in case my priority queue size is 0, then I have to return 0 here. Okay. One more thing. Here you might have seen that it is mentioned this question is asked in which all companies. Okay, I have not taken Leetcode Premium, as you can see editorial section is logged here. This is an extension that I have downloaded from Google Chrome. You can also try it. This will be very beneficial for you. The name of the extension is Big Omega. Okay, you can go to Google Chrome and write Big Omega. There you will find this extension. Download it, and then you'll be able to see the name of the companies that have asked the particular question in the interview rounds. Okay, so I hope you have understood the approach, intuition, and the code. I'll see you tomorrow. Thank you so much.